for Chaitanya and the need for his appearance have been set forth in 6 verses. Last one, 277. श्री रूप रघुनाथ भजे जाराश चैतन्य चरितामृत कहे कृष्णदास प्रेइंग एट द लोटस फीट ऑफ श्री रूप एंड श्री रघुनाथ ऑलवेज डिजायरिंग देयर मर्सी ऐ कृष्णदास नरेट श्री चैतन्य चरितामृत फॉलोइंग इन देयर फुटस्टेप्स हरे कृष्ण नमो ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण प्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमती जयपताका स्वामिनीति नामिनी नमो आचार्य पादाय नित्य कृपाय प्रसायिनी गौरकथा दामदाय नगर ग्राम धरि नमो ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण प्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमती भक्ति वेदांत स्वामिनीति नामिनी नमस्ते सारस्वती देवे गौरवाणि प्रत्यानि निर्विशेष शून्यवाद पाशाधारिणि जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत कथाधर श्री गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे राम 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 हरे हरे पंचाकल्पकरूपेश कृपा सिंधुपये पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः अनंतकोटि वैष्णवृंदकि जय थैंक यू प्रभु जी थैंक यू सो मच सो हूएवर मीट नारद महर्षि दे विल मीट कृष्ण फॉर श्योर एग्जांपल प्रह्लाद महाराज ध्रुव महाराज रत्नाकर लेटर ऑन वाल्मीकि महर्षि एंड सो ऑन लिस्ट इज एंडलेस Like that, whoever meet Ramananda Kannaiya Prabhu, definitely they will be situated in peaceful state, no doubt. So in this way, Ramananda Kannaiya Prabhu is taking initiative to give the nectar to Chaitanya Charitamrita. Krishna's words, Bhagavad Gita, Krishna's activities, Srimad Bhagavatam, Krishna's mind, Chaitanya Charitamrita. So understand mind of Krishna is very difficult. We could not understand our own mind. We could not understand our relatives, friends, neighbors, even our wife mind. After 30 years, 40 years, 50 years also, living together, leading Gregasa life, 40th anniversary, husband asking wife, I could not understand your mind. This is Kali Yuga. So, Ramananda Kannaiya Prabhu taking initiative to understand Krishna's mind, somehow with the help of senior devotees and exalted Vaishnavas. Hari Bol, thank you Prabhuji, thank you so much. In the sloka 262, everybody listening, no? Hari Bol?
Yes, Prabhu.
Hari Bol, okay. Hama haite radha paya je jatiya sukha, thaha asvadite ami sada unmukha. So jatiya sukha, what is it? Jatiya sukha, special, Krishna saying here. I am always eager to taste the joy that Radharani derives from me. Jadiya Sukha and Unmukha, very eager. Always, Sadai, always, Sada, always Unmukha. Enjoy that one. What is it? Sukha. So Krishna is telling here, Bhagavad Gita, Matta Pradaram Nanyat Kinjit Asti Dhananjaya, Mahi Saram Idam Proktam Sutre Manikana Iva. Very clear mention here. There is no truth superior to me. Everything rest upon me. Very clear. And again, Kantra is telling, Dehi Pada Pallavam Udaram. Krishna is requesting Radharani, please give your lotus feet, I want to serve you. He is requesting Radharani, Dehi Pada Pallavam Udaram. This looks Kantra, isn't it? Actually, Krishna and Radharani, Ekatattvam. One in Krishna Loka. They want to release, they want to exhibit the Madhurya Bhava to the devotee, his own devotees. That's why in Krishna Leela they separated. Again, they united in Gaura Leela together. This is a tattva. Krishna told second sloka 263. In spite of various effort, I have not been able to taste it, but my desire to release that pressure increases as I smell its sweetness. So Krishna telling here, you want to enjoy the sweetness. Whatever is released in Krishna Leela is not enough. He has tried so many ways to release that mellow what Radharani is enjoying. Three main reason already so many devotees discussed. Three confidential reason for the internal reason already discussed by senior devotees. We want to go to in depth again and again. So Krishna tried so many times to fulfill his desire. For example, Julan festival also. Julan Krishna pulled very fast and jumped on the Julan. Radharani hugged very tightly. This moment Krishna was expecting, it was happened. Even though not satisfied. So many incidents like this. So Krishna become mad about this son. Is it possible Krishna become mad? Yes, Krishna become mad. So towards Radharani, Radha Prema. So explain this sloka, Krishnadasa Kaviraj Goswami writing directly Krishna's words. Purnananda maya ami, chinmaya purna tattva, radharaya prema ami, karaya unmatta. Unmatta means madness. Krishna become mad. Purnananda maya ami, chaitanya maya purna tattva. Radha kara prema ami, karaya unmatta. I am the full spiritual truth. I am made of full joy, but the love of Srimati Radharani drives me mad. What is man? What does mean? And again, continuous sloka is there. Radhikara Prema Guru Ami Shishyanata. Shishyanata Sada Ami Nana Nitya Nachaya Unbatha Udbatha. The love of Radhika is my teacher, Guru, and I am her dancing student, dancing pupil. Her prema makes me dance various novel dances. Adilila 4-1-2-1, 1-2-4. We are already this one. So Krishna's telling is Radha prema is guru for me. So Krishna tried so many ways. Generally, we'll talk. Any common person becoming mad, these three factors are explained by the acharyas. What are the three factors? The person who is completely absorbed, completely deluded in this material subject matter and deeply absorbed and excessively absorbed in that subject matter, it is a root cause for the becoming madness. And second one is insufficient capacity. For example, Acharya has already given an example here. For example, 60 watts bulb, you are introducing 1000 watts current, bulb will burst. Like that, maybe insufficient capacity. This is like second reason for becoming mad. Third reason is less understanding of subject matter because of the ignorance. It is also possible to become madness for the subject matter. So in these three reasons, is it applicable for Krishna? No, not at all applicable. Because Krishna says, Krishna is completely Purna. Krishna is Purna Brahma, completely full. Krishna is Advaita Jnana, Tattva, is absolute truth. Krishna is Apta Kama, self-satisfied. Krishna is Atmarama, he who enjoys his own self. Paramananda Sarupa, he is the source and the resource of all mellows. Rasaraja, he is the yogis, he is all the yogis, jnanis, bhaktas, meditating on his own lotus feet. Then Mukhya Kavuna, chief and secondary mellows of all exist. Then Anandamaya is completely blissful, supremely situated. Then where is the point of excessive absorbed? That means first point is ruled out. Krishna is not coming in the line. Second point is not less capacity. No. Because he is Ananta, he is supreme and unlimited. There is no point of second also applicable. The third point is insufficient knowledge because of ignorance. All you talk about ignorance. Ignorance, there is no question of ignorance. Maya creates by Krishna only. So he is a Maya Disha, not Maya Vasa. He is the source of full knowledge. He is Sachidananda, Sachidanandamaya, Jnanamaya, Satmaya, Sitmaya, Anandamaya, Jnanamaya. Then what is it? What is it? Talk of less intelligent because of ignorance. So these three not applicable. Even though even sloka says here, Radha Prema is my guru. Radha Kara Prema Guru. Ami Sishya Nata. I am the Sishya of Radha Guru. What does it mean? So Krishna tried various times. It looks like a madness. We will see one by one. What are the Krishna Leela? Indicates Krishna act as a madness. Krishna waiting the whole night behind a berry tree, afraid of Jatila Kutila to meet Radharani the whole night behind the various trees. Is it indicates madness or not? First one. Second one is waiting on the path of Radharani comes and goes for a long time, hoping she will come, she will give darshan. This also indicates Krishna's madness for Radha Prema. Second, become wife of barber and bring red color alta. It is a white color powder. It is applied on the women feet. So become as a wife of barber. This is called a Napitini. Napitini. So become wife of barber and bring red color alta, applying on women feet and bringing and knocking the door. Radharani, I brought very excellent, colorful alta for you. Please come out. I will apply for you. Is it indicating madness or not? Third one is as a beggar woman and begging alms in front of Radharani door, house door, and covering his wife face with a sari and begging as a beggar in front of Radharani house. This also one. And a wife of a gardener, become a makeup, doing makeup as a wife of a gardener and preparing mala and going to knocking the door of Radharani. I brought very excellent mala for you. Please come out. It is very good for your neck. Please come. I'll put you. And Krishna showing this face like that. And become a washerman, wife of washerman, asking cloth. Please give your cloth. I'll wash and give you nicely ironing and give you. This is one more Leela. So Krishna acting again and again, wife of sandalwood paste preparing, wife of the sandalwood maker, sandalwood paste maker, and became is called Gandini, and knocking the Radharani's house and telling, I brought very nice sandal pulp and scent, very scent for you, very good for you, please come out. We are requesting and begging Radharani. She was Radharani. She times, sometimes Krishna embraces a golden color creeper and crying, where is Radharani, Radharani? Sometimes taking dust of Radharani path where she is walking, has trodden upon and smears all his body and crying, Radha, 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 Radha. So jumping, running here and there. Sometimes Radharani taking bath in the upstream of the river, and Krishna taking downstream of the river, then the kungumam, Radharani applied kungumam on the forehead and the flowers on the bridal hair. It should float on the water and it should go touches Krishna's body. So it's Krishna's expecting, and he's also taking bath in that way to enjoy the Krishna prema. He's also indicating the Krishna's madness. And jumping and running here and there, jumping in the Kesigata and shouting, Kothaya go Premamaya Radha Radhe, Radhe Radhe go Jay Radhe Radhe, shouting here and there. Deka Diya Prana Rako Radhe Radhe, Tomara Kangara Tomaya Deke Radhe Radhe. Acharya writes here. What a beautiful words. Kothaya, where are you? Show your darshan, Radha, go Radha. Please show your darshan. Kothaya go Premamayi Radha Radha. Shouting in the Kesigata and running towards the Vamsivatta, again coming to the Nidhuvana. Again coming to Kunjavana, again coming to Kusumavana, again coming to Govardhana, again going to Thalavana, again going to Tamalavana, again he shed tears like a torrential rain. Mukhe Radha Radha Bole Bhashe Nayana Jala Radha Radha Goje Radha Radha Kothaya Go Preme Radha, shouting Krishna again and again. This means Krishna become very, very madness to attain the Radha Prema. So here, Krishna is Saranavatsala. Krishna actually mad or not? Krishna is Sarva Shaktiman, completely full of pleasure, happiness, completely Jnanamaya, full of knowledge, even still becoming mad after Radha Prema. Restlessly shouting Radha, 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 Radha. So Bhakta Bhava Angikari, accepting the concept of being a devotee, here as we discussed at the beginning, so Gaura Sundara again took the form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They exhibit this Leela. We are one only because Krishna, Radharani is the internal potency of Sri Krishna. Without energy, there is no. We cannot exhibit. We don't have energy. We sit silently like that. So Krishna wants to take full energy to show the prema to the entire world. That is why Gaura Sundara appeared. So Krishna is having this greed. That is why Sloka says here, 263, in spite of various effort, I have not been able to taste it, but my desire to reach the treasure increases as I smell its sweetness. Nana yatya kari ami nari aswadye se sukha madhurya grihane loba. Loba means greediness. Three kind of greediness. Again, first we discussed in the first root cause. Swadhyo radha. So first is Sri Radha yo pranaya mahima. Is the first greediness. Second one is swadhyo yena adbhuta madhurima. Second greediness. Third one is saukhyam chasya mad. Anubhavataha. Is the third greediness. Loba. That's why he had explained. Second sloka is, formerly I appeared in the world to taste mellows, and I tasted the mellows of pure love in various loves. So Krishna exhibited all rasas, Madhurya rasa, Sakya rasa, and Vadasya rasa, Santa rasa, Vasala rasa, all rasas enjoyed with every devotee is exhibited, but the Madhurya rasa is the topmost rasa. He could not satisfied in that Krishna Leela. That is why he came into that Gaura Leela. But these three desires of mine were not satisfied about it. So one cannot enjoy them in a contrary position, because contrary position, we cannot enjoy this one, the Krishna Leela, because when we see that our own beauty, unless otherwise someone has to express you are more beautiful, or someone otherwise I have to have one mirror, beautiful mirror in front of me. We are Radharani's mirror, and Krishna is enjoying the releasing that own pleasure. So unless I accept the lustre of the ecstatic love of Sri Radhika, these three desires cannot be fulfilled. That is why Gaurachandra taken this frame, this form, and exhibited this Radha Prema, then jumping here and there. So Krishna, there is no Radhika Prema is a mixture of two things are here. Acharya writes here. This mentioned here, Vishamrithe Ekatra Milana. Same time looks like a poison, same time looks like Amrita. What is the controversy statement? Example given Acharyas, when we drink hot sugar cane, our mouth will get burning. Isn't it? When we drink sugar cane juice, it very soothing, very pleasure. Similarly, Radha Prema also looks like a Vishamrita, looks like a poison, and it is like a Amrita, Ekatta Milana, same time. The Acharya like this, right, like this. Krishna always Saranavatsala. So Radha Prema is Nitya Vardhana Shila. Keep on in the white, this Gaura Chandra, and enjoying this one, because in Krishna Leela, Radha preparing prasadam daily, one variety. It is keep on increasing. Nitya Vardhana Sila. Krishna's Radharani Prema is never newer. Increasing. However, Radha Prema is increases at every moment. That is why it is called Nitya Vardhana Sila. Keep on increasing. Visuddha, very clear. Visuddha Sunirmala, completely pure. Vakshagadi, not straight. Vakragadi, not straight. It is keep on, sometimes Vakragadi, sometimes very pure, straight. So no one can understand Radha Prema. Krishna Vande Jagadguru. Krishna says Vande Jagadguru. But Krishna worships Radha Pada Radhikara Prema. We should understand very clearly. Krishna Vande Jagadguru. But Krishna says here, Radha Prema is my Guru. So Guru Ami Sishya Nata. So Krishna says here, I am the dancing puppet, dancing student in front of you. So Radha Prema makes him disciple, dance and mad. Radha Prema, as I discussed, simultaneously Amrutam and Visham, as we drink a hot kind of this one. When Krishna decorated himself as a gopi and going near to the Radhika and telling, looks like your sister, no? Please come to me, hug me. Then Radhika smiling and going away. Then because so many elders are there, so she could not respond as a courtesy and shyness nature of women. She moved from there. She's not responding, and she's not doing anything. So when we talk about the smiling is very nice, because when you see Krishna photo, Krishna picture, Krishna vigraha, always smiling. Smiling is a science. Smiling is a heart. we should learn as a Krishna devotees, we should develop the smiling in our heart. We should discuss a little bit detail in smiling topic. Smiling is very, very essential for Krishna devotees, to cover the devotees, to care of devotees, to develop our own devotional service in Krishna Bhakti. Smiling is very, very important one. So when I'm talking about the smiling, Krishna is exhibiting various points. We'll start from the Gita. When Arjuna bewildered, he dropped his arrow and bow on the chariot and concretely told, "I will not fight." Then starts Krishna chastising and 2.2. Krishna Swam Kasmana Idame. So where you have got these dirty thoughts in this time? Shouted and Anarya will come. This is not good for you. It's infamy. Akirtikaram Arjuna is giving advice. And 2.10 sloka is said, Tam uvacha rishikesa prakasan iva bharata sena rubyur mathye vishidagadantam idam vachaka. In this sloka, prakasan is the iva bharata, word is there. Acharya is purport given here. Krishna smiling, seeing the Krishna Arjuna and smiling, the smiling word Acharya has given six kind of explanation and for the one word smiling. First time Krishna smiling is called parigasam. Parigasam means criticizing smiling. Why? Because already when I am going as an ambassador to Duryodhana assembly, I told you I go to Duryodhana. If I accepted this giving your share, well and good. Not accepted, definitely war will come. All you be prepared. I told those time you are all everybody kept quiet, accepted. Then war already started here. Now you people are after coming war foot. You are telling here I don't want to fight. What is this foolish activity? This one kind of statement. Second one is like a fun kind of smiling, because he is talking one kind of action and talking is a different kind of talking. But because when Draupadi disrobed in that assembly of Duryodhana assembly, then everybody took vow. Pandavas took vow. I will kill Karna, I will kill Bhimasena, I will kill 100 sons, everything. And then only I will Draupadi will tie our hair. Like that, everybody took oath. Then now coming into the Guru Kshetra war, you are talking, I don't want to fight. Second kind of, this is called fun. That's why he's indicating under fun smile. That's why he's talking, not talking based on his action. Second one. Third one is, I'm going to introduce the Vedanta philosophical right now. The Gita going to advent. That's why he's smiling in his very gentle smile. Third one. And fourth one is, you are my bhakta and devotee, and that's why I have compassion towards you as my child with a vasalya bhava. Krishna is smiling with a vasalya bhava. Fifth one is, so I am taking you as a tool to introduce this jnana, because the jnana, the entire world, the jivatmas, it has a pride laughing. Pride smile. This is a fifth explanation. And sixth is, I want to kill all the Gauravas. Like it's called pralaya time smiling. I want to kill all the Gauravas in this, because of you are ignorant. I'm using this one. I want to kill every moment, every time this moment. This is called the pralaya kala life smiling. This indication given. The seventh one is, so I want to give multiple various tattva jnana about the atma, about your body, about karma yoga, jnana yoga, dhyana yoga, all kind of yoga. I want to explain to you like that. Multiple reasons. Bhagavan laughing in this point. So in this point, Krishna also exhibiting so many one word prakasan iva bharata 2.10. Acharya is giving so many explanation. So smiling is the fantastic art. Science. One time Krishna is in the small baby, one mendicant and beggar coming to Yashodama doorstep, Mandabhavan, asking some alms. So Krishna running towards Yashoda, mummy, mata. So that beggar is coming. I don't want to go near the beggar. Maybe the beggar maybe take me in keeping in the big bag he's having. I don't want to leave you. And catching the Yashodama sari, and Yashoda smiling. At the same time, the beggar also smiling. the beggar could not control his smile and laughed loudly. And second time, Krishna is a friend giving food, sharing food, everything. And Krishna, his friends told Krishna, Krishna, open your mouth and close your eyes. We want to give you candy made of yogurt. Then Krishna closed his eyes and they put, instead of giving yogurt made of sweet, they put flour. Krishna nicely sheared the flour and his face different exhibiting different ways, laughing. And all friends are clapping and laughing. Such one kind of laughing. And third, I told Krishna to dress himself as a woman and approaching Radharani. Radharani smiled and gone. And in this way, the laughing and smiling is categorized. Six kind of categories are there. So six kind of categories we discuss. Very fantastic way it is explained in six ways. One is Smita. One is Smita. Second is Asgatya. So I'll give one by one. Fantastic topics given here. How we had learned Krishna smiling. Krishna's, when we have a distress, moros, we stand in front of Krishna's 5 minutes, all will be eradicated. So that is why we should learn, keep 24/7 smiling at any cost. So this is the main discussion. And Smita. Smita means when one is smiling but his teeth not visible, one can distinctly mark a definite change in the eyes and in the cheek. This is called Smita smiling. So one time, Krishna was stealing yogurt in his own house, Nandabhavan. Then the head servant, head maid, the maid servant's name is Jarati. Jarati is chasing Krishna. See, Krishna is a paramporal. So Krishna, Jarati has a chance. We know Yasodhamma only chasing Krishna. No, Jarati, housemaid also chasing Krishna to catch Krishna because Krishna is stealing butter in her own Nandabhavan. So chasing Krishna, running towards Balrama and casualing Balrama's dress and telling, Bhaiya, Bhaiya, this Jarati is chasing me to catching. I try to steal butter in our own house. Then Balrama smiling. The same time, all 33 crores, devatas also smiling from the spiritual world. Balrama smiling. This kind of smell is called Smita. This smile, our lips will not open, teeth will not appear. It is called Smita smiling. Krishna's always smiling. We can see the picture, Krishna Balram picture. Krishna showing head towards Balrama. Balrama smiling without opening his teeth. Smita smile. Second is Hasita smile. Hasita smile is which is teeth are slightly visible. When we see the Murali Krishna photo, Krishna is holding left hand on his head and two parrots are there and Krishna holding flute in his right hand and smiling. In this picture, you can see Krishna's teeth are slightly visible. This is called Murali Krishna. This is called Asita smiling. In this pastime, Krishna was in that Radharani house one time. Right? By the time Abhimanyu, husband Abhimanyu came from outside, immediately Krishna became as Abhimanyu and Jatila. He ran to Jatila, mommy, mommy, mother, mother, I am your real son. Krishna has become coming me like this. He's teasing, he's changing the plate in front of Jatila. Jatila chastising his own son Abhimanyu. The scene, seeing that all gopis are laughing, this also their teeth are visible. This is called Asita, one of our example. The third is when all the gopis are taking bath with Krishna in the Yamuna river. All the gopis are laughing with their own ecstatic level. The teeth are visible. This also Asita level. Third one is Vigasita. When the teeth are distinctly visible in a smile, that is called a Vigasita smile. One day when Krishna was engaged in stealing butter with yogurt in the house, Jatila house, Krishna is stealing butter. By the time Jatila was sleeping, Krishna was thinking like that. But Jatila not sleeping actually. She was looks like a sleeping and wake up and saw Krishna sleeping, stealing the butter. Then she uncontrollably, she laughed. This kind of laugh is called Vigasita laughing. Then fourth one is called the same way when Krishna playing with the gopas in the Vrindavana also, children, friends are laughing. This is also this kind of laughing. And the fourth one laughing is we are discussing in that point. அவக சீதா இந்த ஸ்டேட் ஆஃப் ஸ்மைலிங் வென் த நோஸ் பிகம்ஸ் பஃப்டு அந்த ஐஸ் ஸ்பின் ஸ்பின்ட் த ஸ்மைல் இஸ் கால்டு அவக சீதா ஒன் எர்லி த மார்னிங் கிருஷ்ணா ரிட்டர்ன் ஹோம் பர்ஃபார்மிங் ராதர் டான்ஸா மை டியர் சன் ரசதம் ஆஸ்கிங் மை டியர் சன் வை டூ யூ ஐஸ் லுக் லைக் ஸ்மேர்ட் வித் சம் ஆக்சிடைஸ் ஹாவ் யூ ட்ரெஸ்ட் யுவர் செல்ஃப் வித் த ப்ளூ கார்மெண்ட்ஸ் பலதேவா யூ டுடே ஆஸ்கிங் அண்ட் கிருஷ்ணா ஸ்மைலிங் அண்ட் அகெயின் அதர் கோபிஸ் ஆர் சீயிங் தட் சீன் அண்ட் கோபிஸ் ஆர் ஸ்டார்ட் ஸ்மைலிங் இஸ் கால்டு அவகசிதா ஸ்மைலிங் கோபி நியூ தட் கிருஷ்ணா ஹேட் பீன் என்ஜாயிங் த ரச டான்ஸ் தட் மதர் யசோதா குட் நாட் டிடெக்ட் அவர் சன்ஸ் ஆக்டிவிட்டீஸ் ஆர் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஹவு ஹி ஹேட் பிகம் கவர்ட் வித் கோபிஸ் மேக்கப் அவர் ஸ்மைலிங் வாஸ் இன் த அவகசிதா ஃபீச்சர் ஃபிஃப்த் ஒன் இஸ் அப அசிதா அபாசிதா மீன்ஸ் வென் டியர்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் த ஐஸ் ஆர் ஆடட் டு த ஸ்மைலிங் அண்ட் லாஃபிங் அண்ட் த ஷோல்டர்ஸ் ஆர் ஷேக்கிங் ஸ்மைல் இஸ் கால்டு அபாசிதா வென் சைல்டு கிருஷ்ணா வாஸ் டான்சிங் ரெஸ்பான்ஸ் டு சிங்கிங் ஆஃப் ஓல்டு மேட் சர்வெண்ட் ஜரதி நாரதா வாஸ் அஸ்ட்ரோனிஸ்டு நாரதா ஆல்சோ சீயிங் திஸ் ஒன் டான்சிங் ஸோ சுப்ரீம் பர்சன் ஆஃப் காட் ஹூ கண்ட்ரோல் ஆல் த மோட்டி மூவ்மெண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் கிரேட் டெமிகாட்ஸ் லார்ட் பிரம்மா ஹூ நவ் டான்சிங் இண்டிகேஷன் ஆஃப் ஆல் ஓல்டு ஓல்டு மேட் சர்வெண்ட் ஜரிதா சீயிங் திஸ் ஃபன் நாரதா ஆல்சோ பிகன் டு டான்ஸ் அண்ட் இஸ் ஷோல்டர் ட்ரம்பிள்டு ஐஸ் ஆர் மூவ்டு திஸ் கால்டு அபஹசிதா லாஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் அதிஹசிதா வென் எ ஸ்மைலிங் பர்சன் கிளாப்ஸ் இஸ் ஹேண்ட் அண்ட் லீப்ஸ் இஸ் ஹேர் அண்ட் ஸ்மைலிங் எக்ஸ்பிரஸிங் சேஞ்சஸ் இன் டு அதிஹசிதா ஆர் ஓவர்வெல்மிங் லாஃப்டர் திஸ் கால்டு அதிஹசிதா ஸ்மைலிங் மை டியர் குட் உமன் த ஸ்கின் ஆஃப் யுவர் ஃபேஸ் இஸ் நவ் ஸ்லாக்கண்ட் and your face exactly resembling that of a monkey as such the king of monkeys balimukha has selected you as your worthy wife krishna is criticizing the maid servant while krishna was teasing jarati in this way she replied that she was certainly aware of the fact that the king of the monkey was trying to marry her but she had already taken shelter of krishna the killer of many powerful demons and therefore she had already decided to marry krishna instead of the king of the monkeys this is in this way hearing this sarcastic reply by the active jarati all the over covered girls present there began to laugh very loudly and clap their hands such a laughter accompanied by the clapping hands and called adi asita so in this way we should develop smiling and in this way we can bring near to heart smiling is the best tool to bring the devotee's heart by heart that's why krishna says here sugridam sarva bhutanam I am very close I am very dear friends of everyone sugridam krishna says I am not saying only saying sugridam not kidney or lungs or any other part hridayam I am sugridam sarva bhutanam we should develop the smiling character that's why when you see that ramananda kanaya prabhu picture is smiling and the head is down seeing the head bhumi devi why because he cherishing his lotus feet of shiksha guru and gurudeva guru maharaj that's why his head is downside bhumi devi and always smiling face you can see the dp photo of ramananda kanaya prabhu so in this way we are concluding last shloka to 260 271 so 260 270 says சேயி காலேஷி அத்வைத கரேனே சோ 269 சோ கிருஷ்ணா டிசைடட் டு டேக் த கௌரசுந்தர அவதாரா தென் ஹி ஹஸ் டேக்கன் திஸ் கௌரசுந்தர ஃப்ரம் கிருஷ்ணசுந்தரா ஃப்ரம் கௌரசுந்தர அண்ட் 270 இயர் அத்வைத ஆச்சாரியா வர்ஷிப்டு வித் துளசி பத்ரா அண்ட் ஷாலிகிராம டு கம் டு த மெட்டீரியல் வேர்ல்ட் டு சேவ் த பீப்புள் அண்ட் 271 and 72 discuss here krishna pita mata guru kana aake avatari yes pita mata guru kana avatari aake avatari radhikara bhava varna ke gara kari so your parents sachi mata and சாக்ஷாத் கிருஷ்ணர் ஸோ பேரண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் அப்பியர்ட் பிஃபோர் தென் சசி மாதா ஊம் இஸ் கம்பேர்ட் டு இஸ் மில்கி ஓஷன் அண்ட் ஃப்ரம் மில்கி ஓஷன் பூர்ணச்சந்திரா அப்பியர்ட் அண்ட் பகவான் அக்செப்டட் இஸ் ஏ கோல்டன் ஃபார்ம் 73 எக்ஸ்பிளைன்ஸ் இயர் ஐ எம் கேச்சுவலிங் இஸ் ரூப கோஸ்வாமி இஸ் லோட்டஸ் ஃபீட் அண்ட் எக்ஸ்பிளைன்ட் இஸ் 5th 6th ஸ்லோகாஸ் We'll come to the 277, 275 slokas here. Fantastic sloka. Only one. Give me 5 minutes. Stavamala is explained. Third sloka. Aparam kashyami. Aparam kashyami pranayi janavrutasya kuru kuduhi. Asastomam grutva madram ubhoktum kam abhiyakayam. Usam swam avrutyayam ikadiyam pragadayan. Avesh sa deva shaitanyakrit adhidharam. Adhidharam na prabhayatu. Fantastic sloka here. Rupa Goswami explains very nicely. Lord Krishna decided to taste the limitless material mellows of love of one his multitude of loving damsels, Radha, and so he has assumed a form of Lord Chaitanya. He has tested that love while hiding his own dark complexion with her effulgent yellow color. May that Supreme Personality of God, Lord Chaitanya, show his great causeless mercy, worshipping, is requesting Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to shower mercy. In that same verses, sixth verses is beautifully explained here. Mukhenagre pitva maduram ihe namamrita rasam Vishnor dhruva yastam vamati gana pashpampu mistaha bhuvi premas tatvam prakashitam ullasita tanu sadeva chaitanya krutar adhidharam na krubayathu. So to reveal the truth of pure transcendental love in this world, he first jubilantly drank with his mouth the nectar of the holy name and then destroyed it from eyes on the pretext of shedding tears. May that Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Chaitanya, show us his great causeless mercy. So Sri Stavamala, fantastic book composed by Rupa Goswami. So whoever having time, please release this book, fantastic. Yashi, one more prayer is there, very fantastic there. Yashya padam buja bhakti labhyan premam buddha premam buddha prema prema vidha prema vidhana parama puman artha तस्मै जगन मंगल मंगलाय चैतन्य चैतन्य चंद्राय नमो नमस्ते. एंड वन मोर प्रेयर इज देयर. आनंद लीलामय विग्रहाय एमाव दिव्य दिव्य चावि सुंदराय तस्मै महाप्रेम रस प्रदाय चैतन्य चंद्राय नमो नमस्ते. ओ लॉर्ड चैतन्य चंद्रा, ओ लॉर्ड हूज फॉर्म इज फुल ऑफ ब्लिसफुल पास्ट टाइम, ओ लॉर्ड हूज कॉम्प्लेक्शन इज एन स्प्लेंडेड as gold, O Lord, who given his charity the nectar of a pure love for Lord Krishna, I offer my respectful obeisances unto you. So the excellent prayers. Ananda Leela Maya Vigrahaya Emamba Divya. So this is already read. So that's why Rupa Goswami concluded the 77th sloka. 76 Mangalacharanam Krishna Chaitanya Tattva Lakshanam Prayojanam Savadare Sloka Sakte Nirupitam. So is concluding 277 sloka. Every chapter concluding with the Rupa Goswami Rupa Raghunatha Pade Jara Ashya Chaitanya Chaitamrita Kake Krishna Dase. Time is there or not? I'm keep on talking. 1 minute, 5 minutes. So when we have the desire to please Krishna, first we have to catch hold Acharya's lotus feet, then only our desire will be fulfilled automatically. In this way, here author Krishnadasa Kaviraj Goswami worshipping his own acharyas and to fulfill the desire. So because Krishna is immediately responding his own devotees, pure devotees, because they are tattva darshis, Krishna is immediately responding the prayer of pure devotees. That's why we have to catch hold acharyas lotus feet to attain Krishna's abode, to attain our desire. In this connection, we will narrate small pastimes happened in Ramanuja Acharya's life history. This is 5 minutes. Ramanuja Acharya was one time taking class in Tirupati. During summer time, hot, very hot. All disciples feeling very thirsty and hungry also. By the time, very old woman carrying a buttermilk pot and came near the team. So she thought, so this is a very crowd is there. When we go, our pot will be empty. We can go, make good business. She came there and requested all the brahmanas, please take one cup of buttermilk, everybody. So I want to empty out my pot. Please help me. She requested. The same time, all brahmanas also feeling thirsty, and they saw the Ramanujacharya permission. So Ramanujacharya given permission. Okay, no problem. You take. You have that one. Then everybody happily drank two cups, three cups as my required. Then pot is empty. Then she felt so happy. Then Ramanujacharya asked the women how much amount money you need. Then she told she to for a moment she thinking. Then she thought, I don't want money. I need your mercy. She told like that. What kind of mercy you need? So I need your mercy to attain salvation, to attain moksha prapti. So she requested. Then Ramanujacharya was laughing. What is this? How can I give you moksha prapti? What is this? So you came for business. You can take money, some gold, or you want some gold, something. We are monk sannyasis. We don't have anything. So you take some money, you go. Then she don't want to give up her own desire. I want moksha prapti. It is possible by you only. Please sanction me. She requested again and again. Then Ramanujacharya thinking again, what we have to do now? So she asked, he asked, what do you want? Finally, tell me. She asked, I need your recommendation to get salvation. Please recommend to Lord Balaji. Okay, how can I recommend? Okay, I'll pray. I'll do prayer for you to get salvation, moksha prapti. Don't worry, you go. Then she don't want to go. I need your authorization letter now. So she's insisting again and again. What authorization letter? Yes, please give me a letter to Lord Balaji. I take the letter. Then I'll be satisfied. I'll go to approach Lord. Then Ramanujacharya, now no other way. So she told one of disciple, go and bring the palm leaf and the writing nail. So everybody excited. What is going to happen? What is happening here? Then one disciple brought the palm leaf and one writing nail. Then everybody seeing the palm leaf, what is going to write in the palm leaf? Then he wrote two address, Sri Sri Lord Balaji, Tirupati Devastan, and from address, Dasan Ramanujan. And the body letter, please give the moksha prapti of this poor woman, buttermilk seller. This is your humble servant, Ramanujan. He wrote the letter and gave to that woman to satisfy the woman, go. So we'll pray the Supreme Lord for your moksha. Then the woman taking the letter ran like a wind to going to the Garbhagraha, Lord Balaji temple inside. And she met all the Brahmanas doing puja in there. She handed the letter. I got a letter from Ramanuja for my mukti, salvation. Please, hand over this letter to Lord Balaji. Then everybody laughing. Are you mad? What happened to you? So getting salvation, bring letter. Is it possible? Go away. They're chastising, sending out. Then she not giving up their desire. She's crying like anything in front of all Brahmanas. Please help me. Ramanujacharya, give me letter. Please help me. Then everybody thinking what we have to do now. Then head pujari came. He advised. The letter came from Ramanuja. Higher authority, don't neglect. Whatever do, we will do. They take the accept the letter. Keep the lotus feet of the Lord Balaji and do prayer on behalf of the women and do daily sadhana, daily puja as usual. Then side by side, do the prayer prarthana for the women also. By the time, though they did accepted the instruction from the chief Purohit, then all Brahmanas started keeping the letter under the lotus feet of Lord Balaji and doing prayer on behalf of the women and doing the daily nitya karmas. Then immediately from the Vigraha, one hand extended and taken the letter from the bottom of the Vigraha. Immediately Akashavani informed moksha prapti tadastu. So moksha liberation sanctioned, granted to the women. The voice Akashavani came. Immediately Pushpaka Vimanam came from the spiritual world. The buttermilk seller traveled to spiritual world. This happened 1,000 years back, Ramanujacharya life history. So when we catch hold the Acharya's lotus feet, definitely we can attain Krishna's lotus feet. Hare Krishna. Thank you so much. Any comment? Hari Bol. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Prabhu, thank you very much. Wonderful session. You've taken us to different routes. Finally, you brought us back to where we started. So amazing pastimes of Lord Ramanujacharya with Kottamil Seller. It is really amazing for us to understand the mercy of spiritual master. And say the causeless mercy of spiritual master can come like this. So what spiritual master says, Lord cannot deny. Whether it's qualified, not qualified, like exactly what happened with Srila Prabhupada's disciples those days. They don't know anything. They don't know who is Krishna. They don't know who is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Prabhupada said, Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. They said, yeah, okay, Prabhupada. So they don't know anything. And then Prabhupada said, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Supreme Personality of Godhead. They said, okay, Prabhupada. For us, even Indians also, it is very difficult accept Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as Supreme Personality of Godhead. Whereas Prabhupada's disciples, those days, they don't know even who is Krishna. Forget about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So even that situation, they simply said, yes, Prabhupada. So they started following his instructions. That is the reason now all those are the exalted Vaishnavas. Today, Maharajas delivering thousands and thousands of fallen souls. It is that shows the causeless mercy of spiritual master and pure devotee. Thank you very much, Roo. It's wonderful past time. It's very nice. And also, you explained about the six types of smiles. I never heard, rather, for that matter. I never heard. So it is definitely gives us, we can use this in our pitching, this one also. Can you, Prabhu, can you please share the gist of this in the group, if you don't mind? Because we could not write the six smiles and what it is and how. You can just post it in the group, that will help us, Prabhu.
Yeah, sure, sure, Prabhu, sure. Prabhuji, strictly speaking, I learned from you, Prabhuji, how to smile.
Very good.
Very well.
The photo what you are referring to was actually, it is from Mayapur. Me and my other Shiksha Guru, Radhapati Krishna Prabhu, who is there in the studies class. I think you are referring to that for that picture.
Yes.
Anyway, thank you very much, Prabhu. Thanks for a wonderful class. So, any questions, comments from devotees? We have a few more minutes time before we
move. I seek blessings from Sriman Raghavendra Rao Prabhuji and Srimadi Raghavendra Prabhuji, parents of His Grace Ramanakanya Prabhu parents. They are senior Vaishnava, senior devotees in this group. Please bless me, Prabhuji and Mataji. If I conveyed something to everybody, all credit goes to Ramananda Kanaya Prabhu. If not so, please forgive me, bless me. I can improve my preaching. Hari Hari. Thank you, Prabhu. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Prabhu. Radhaji and Prabhu, you have something to ask?
Yes, Prabhuji, please.
Radhaji and Prabhu? Prabhu, you have to unmute.
No, Prabhu. No, nothing, nothing.
Thank you, Prabhu. So, any other questions, comments by other any devotees?
Hare Krishna, Prabhu. Can I ask?
Yes, Prabhu, please.
So, thank you, Prabhu, for a wonderful class. I have one question in general. In the end of every chapter, Kabiraj Goswami, he is paying obeisances to Rupa Goswami and Raghunath Das Goswami.
Yeah.
They are basically Abhideya Acharya and Prayojan Acharya. But Sanatana Goswami, he is not paying obeisances. Who is Sambandha Acharya? Can you explain that, Prabhu?
Already they connected, Prabhuji. They connected with Sanatana Goswami also. Not, doesn't mean that they are connected only with this Rupa Goswami. Already they connected. It is understood. There is so many reasons behind that one. They are connected, this answer.
Well, actually, as Prabhu rightly mentioned, they are already included. When Rupa Goswami's name is mentioned, because there he is basically referring to Shiksha Gurus. So we will have more than one, multiple Shiksha Gurus. So by referring to the prominent ones, he is actually giving respect, offering respect to the whole parampara of his Shiksha Gurus. So otherwise, not with any intention to leave somebody's name. We can't fit in all the Shiksha Gurus' names in one sloka, because why he is mentioning this also is every chapter, and we need to understand that without mercy of Shiksha Guru, nothing is possible. So first credit goes to Shiksha Guru, then he takes us to spiritual master. And so it is a parampara he is referring to by referring only one or two names. So no any specific reason as per me, as per my understanding. Maybe if others have something different to add, they are welcome.
Yeah. Nice. This is the answer. Already connected in the parampara, so there's no significant immediately. Already there in the link. Already. Yeah.
Thank you, Prabhu.
Hare Krishna.
Prabhu.
Thank you, Prabhu.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Prabhu Purushottam Prabhu.
Yeah, just I want to say it's very nice class. Very nicely Prabhu has explained. I don't know how time has passed. Really wonderful lecture by the Prabhu. Really, I pay my obeisances to unto his lotus feet. Very nicely he has explained.
Prabhupada ki jai.
Thank you, Prabhu. So, we are going to have two more exciting sessions from next week. As mentioned before, those who have joined recently, for information, anyway, we are going to post in the group. We are going to have recap of the chapter 4. It is amazing chapter, but very, very deep, deep subject. So we are going to have Avadhut Prabhu next week. Avadhut Prabhu is a disciple of Radhanatha Maharaj. His expertise in Chaitanya Charitamrita classes. So Prabhu has accepted our request. Prabhu is from ISKCON Devangiri temple. So please don't miss the opportunity. Prabhu said, recap of chapter 4. He said, he was laughing. He said, Prabhu, it is a very vast topic and very deep subject. How can we cover in 1 hour? Then I was thinking, instead of making it 2 hours or 3 hours, I told Prabhu, we'll make it 2 sessions. So Prabhu was happy. So let us take this opportunity to hear from a great Vaishnava about the glories of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So you know, we are going to post the details in the group. So thank you very much once again, Shamsundar Prabhu, for a wonderful class. So with this, we'll just pay pranams to Shamsundar Prabhu, and then we'll end the session today here. Manchakalpatarubhyasya Krupa Sindhu Bhyavacha Paditanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnava.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Shamsundar Prabhu.